with they sell you stuff that is not good for you until it's good for you, just try it. Yeah? You see how many people spend literally billions of dollars on stuff that they're not going to use. Yeah? So the, alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala invited us again to a place He loves most. Nothing about us, it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's the most generous and the most benevolent subhanahu wa ta'ala. Laylatul Qadr is coming over the next 10 nights. Starting tomorrow night, you need counting. Just in case we made a mistake in seeing the moon. So don't just say waiting for the odd night, even night. Yeah? The Prophet never got stuck into this odd night, even night. He go for the 10 night. Yeah? The last 10 night. And the last year he had 20 nights. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. 20 nights of Ramadan i'tikaf. As it said in the khutbah, i'tikaf of the Prophet was in a tent inside the masjid. Not like us. He was inside the tent in the masjid. Incredible. He doesn't even go outside, even though his house is there. This is his house. He had a door to the masjid. And he didn't have any running water inside the masjid. He had to put his head out for his wife to pour the water on it to wash it. That's how much serious, how dedicated he is, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to catch Laylatul Qadr and to teach us about Laylatul Qadr. So in Laylatul Qadr is the time for dua. It's time, this is Ramadan, brothers, sisters, this is Ramadan, time for forgiveness, time for prize giving. Every single night of the month of Ramadan, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, every single night there's a prize giving. Every single night Allah is beautifying Jannah even more. Every single night. So today we talk about how to make dua. So we did the sunnah of eating, sunnah of drinking, sunnah of going to the house, sunnah of getting into the car. And Harith will tell us, what is the sunnah for getting in the car? What do you say? You can say, I can hear from there. You know. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. This Harris can do it. If you say it in the mic, you win the $20. MashaAllah. A little Harris did it. Just get Harris to do the dua for getting in the car. Or the plane tomorrow.
Subhanan nasi suhana hasa makunna humu'inin wa inna ila rupina namukul pun amin.
MashaAllah. Can you pass it to him? MashaAllah. Harris, well done. Well done. Subhanan ladhi sakhara lana hadha wa ma kunna lahu muqrinin. وَإِنَّا إِلَىٰ رَبِّنَا لَمُنْقَلِبُونَ. Every time you get in the car, if you don't know the dua, or until you know the dua, you remember Allah. You remember that my grandfather and your grandfather maybe was riding a donkey somewhere. Yeah? My great-grandfather, your great-grandfather, maybe he was just, you know, I don't know, walking in a desert somewhere. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us luxury on top of luxuries. Cars with ACs and heaters and even motors to heat the seats and put up and down and all this air vents. This is blessing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say. Did he say thank you for all this? The idea is from Allah. The ideas of the airbag and heaters and air cons, and it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything. Allah khalaqakum wa ma ta'amaloon, Allah says. So the Muslim believe that even the idea that the non-Muslim say, oh, I got it. Where did he get it from? Just a second before he didn't even know. That light moment is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Muslim say, glory be to Allah. Subhanalladhi sakharana hadha. It's Allah that made oil. Allah that made metal. Allah that made, you know, electricity. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the brain. Allah that made the writing, the reading. the way we speak to explain the idea to each other. Allah says, Ar-Rahman, علم القرآن, خلق الإنسان, علمه البيان. Allah says, He gave the human being something He didn't give to any other creation. Bayan. Bayan is eloquency. To be able to train each other. Animals, you get a monkey for the next billion years, he will still be a monkey. He will never be able to use iPhone. He will never be able to text another monkey or teach another monkey how to text. No way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if you're mute, even if you're blind, even if you do, you still be able to communicate. Subhanallah. So the Muslim always reflect. Allah says in the Quran, فَلْيَنْظُرِ الْإِنسَانِ إِلَىٰ طَعَامِهِ. Human being, look at the food. Just look at the food and reflect. The shape of the food, the fragrance of the food, the taste of the food. Where is it from? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala could have made us all eat potatoes. All the time, 3 meals a day. No colors. But He gave us colors and taste to enjoy. And then, say, Ya Allah, thank you so much. Thank you so much. So this is the time, the end of the month of Ramadan is the time to reap the reward. It's the time to call on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the sunnah for dua is to thank Allah first. You cannot go to the king and say to the king, give me $20. Allah, give me a house. No, no, no. Allah is the king of the universe. You say, Ya Allah, thank you for this life. Thank you for the family. Thank you for the house. Thank you. You thank Allah for something. And Ya Allah, I need something. I need this and this. You name what you want. And the Shaykh, every single rak'ah we say, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen first. Thank you Allah for everything. Then we say, Ihdina Salatul Mustaqim. Then we ask. You have to thank Allah. You have to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first. And then you thank the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam who taught us how to make dua. How do you thank the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? We say, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, one of the great companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, very close to the Prophet. He heard somebody making dua and did not make salam to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. He says, ajil hadha. This was rushing. This is not a proper dua. His dua will be hanged in the sky. It's not going to go up to Allah till he makes salam on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So we can't thank the Prophet, but we can ask Allah, Ya Allah, send peace and blessing on Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his family. So that is the manners of dua. You thank Allah and you say, Ya Allah, please, I can't thank the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You send peace and blessing on him. Then you name your dua. Then you end it also by thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's like, I tell you something, it's really nice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He loves him. So if you say, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad, you make dua, Ya Allah, send peace of Muhammad, of course, he will accept that from you. And you ask for yourself. And then you say, Oh Allah, send peace of Muhammad. Allah will accept that from you. So you sandwich your dua between two accepted dua. Allah is the most kind. He will not take your dua away. He will answer your dua as well. He will answer your dua as well. I tell you a quick story that happened in Dubai recently. It was on TV. I've said this in Lawahat, I'm not sure if you, I must tell it to you. I repeat myself often, so forgive me if you heard it from me before. Otherwise, I take the $20 back from her. So, this Dubai billionaires, very rich, successful businessman in Dubai, had a problem at home. No problem with money, at home. He has issues, his son is in Europe, is this and that, you know. So he's walking up at the street just to, you know, relax. He's really had a problem at home. And he's walking in the street just aimlessly. It was on TV and they asked him, what is the moment that changed your life? So he says, I was having issues and I was walking by just on the streets, wandering around. And then I heard the Asr Azan, just find nearest masjid. He walks in the masjid, he pray, and he find that Muslim, okay, it's nice to sit, just sit and relax in the masjid. Everybody's gone, but all he hears is somebody making dua. And he looks around and he finds somebody somewhere in the corner of the masjid making sincere, looks like very sincere, sincere dua. And he started to watch this man. He can't hear what he's asking. He wants to help. He says, this man in desperate need, maybe I can help him. But he can't hear what he's saying. So he goes closer and he waits Then the man finished dua. And then he asked him, brother, I see you and you affected me so much. You look so sincere, but you look like you're in desperate need. What's your problem? He said, I just need 4,000 dirham to pay the rent for the house. Otherwise, my family would be in the street. 4,000 dirham is the coffee that this man sent in the day. He took his wallet out, only 4,000 dirham. He got his wallet out and he said, only 4,000 dirham. Don't give food, no even a single dirham extra. That's all I need at the moment. I got a job, but I'm just in some financial difficulty. He gave him the 4,000 dirham and said to him, this is my business card. I am so and so. Billionaire, owner of this business is in Dubai. You need anything, call me. The man says, no, thank you very much. What? Thank you very much. I know who to call when I need anything. I was calling Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah sent you to me. Next time I'll call him again, he will send somebody else. I don't need your business. Amazing, amazing. Not only iman in the heart. And trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reach you that level. So this is the time for dua and time to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. First, thank Allah, say alhamdulillah, shukrullah, for the ni'mah, for the blessing. And oh Allah, please send peace and blessing to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Oh Allah, please help me with my family, help me with my work. Ask Allah for the dunya. The Sahaba used to ask Allah for good quality salt. Don't be ashamed to ask Allah for something. Wallahi, they used to ask Allah for good quality salt for the food. They used to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the pair of shoes. Don't be ashamed to say, oh, I'm going to ask about my work. No, ask Allah. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasana. Give us the best of this life. A job, success, study, home, whatever it is. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in Dubai, also thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sending peace and blessing on the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he used to make dua, he used to put his two hands together. He never separated his two hands from each other. It's like begging, absolutely begging. He put the two hands together near his chest, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Near his chest, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he will make the dua. Yeah? Not closing them and not putting just together like that. Like begging, absolutely begging from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at his chest. He only raised them high in a calamity. In really, really difficult, like the battles. So he will raise his hand above his shoulder, above his head. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And facing the Qibla is recommended. Facing the Qibla. And another amazing, amazing way to make dua is to give sadaqah before. To give sadaqah before dua. Because the Prophet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا إِذَا نَجَيْتُمُ الرَّسُولِ فَقَدِّمُوا بَيْنَ يَدَيْ نَجْوَاكُمْ صَدَقَةً. All you who believe, if you want to have a private conversation with the Prophet, pay sadaqah before you go and purify yourself. You having a private conversation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you need to give sadaqah. What is sadaqah? I'm at home in the middle of the night. What sadaqah? Wallahi, the dollars, the $5, the $10 you give to your wife, to your son, to your daughters is sadaqah. The best sadaqah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you spend money in jihad, or money, you know, for sadaqah, or money for your family, the best money you spend is the one you give to your family. خَيْرُ دِرَهَمْ تُنْفِقْهُ تُنْفِقْهُ عَلَى أَهْلِكَ. So sadaqah in the family. My wife, here's the $100 gift. It's just a gift. It's not the budget. It's not for the food. It's not, no. It's just a gift. Now and then, surprise, a gift. Especially if she's, you know, looking after you and the family and she's not working, she's not earning any her own income. It's a sadaqah. It's the best sadaqah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the sister, if she's working, she gave to the husband too. Ibn Mas'ud did the same. Ibn Mas'ud was a great companion. And his wife used to give him his zakah, her zakah. Because she was rich, he was not. And the Prophet ﷺ said, you get two rewards. You get the reward for zakah and reward for surat al-rahim. Yeah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our dua. And what is the dua? Allahumma innaka afu, tuhibbu al-afu, fa'afu anna, if you want to pray for the whole family. Fa'afu anni, you pray for yourself. Allahumma innaka afu, تحب العفو فاعفو عن. What does it mean? What does it mean in English? When you imagine I'm a teacher at school and I heard you saying اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعفو عنا. I said, oh, Aris, what are you saying?
I heard the Imam say it, I'm just repeating. No, this is not a good answer. You need to, if you don't know the meaning, don't say it. Say it in English, say it in Urdu, say it in Pakistan, whatever it is, say it in a language that comes from the heart and makes you cry. Oh Allah, you all forgiving. Afu, tuhibbu al-afu, you love forgiveness. Forgive me. I don't make mistake. Why? I don't need forgiveness. Someone will say, yes, you don't make mistake, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask you about the use of your eyes. Allah will ask you about the use of your brain. Allah will ask you about the use of your muscles, the use of your memory, the use of your time, the use of your heart. Sincerity. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا أُمِرُوا إِلَّا لِعْبُدُ اللَّهُ مُخْلِصِينَ. Allah says, the only command they were given is to be sincere. Hands up if you're sincere. If you put your hands up, you lost the test. No, you have to work on it till the grave. Sincerity, and to be sincere and dedicated to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So don't be tricked. I don't make any mistake. I'm a decent person. I'm a good person. No, no, no. We need to make, ask Allah forgiveness for our not concentrating in Salah, not concentrating in reading Quran, not concentrating in, you know, in our all our past years. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase us in righteousness and piety. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us Laylat al-Qadr. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us Laylat al-Qadr. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give all of us Laylat al-Qadr. Allahumma innaka afu tuhibbu al-afu fa'afu anna. Allahumma innaka afu tuhibbu al-afu fa'afu anna. Allahumma innaka afu tuhibbu al-afu fa'afu anna. Wa fi da'wana alhamdulillah wa ta'ala. جزاكم الله خير.